Welcome to Neutral Side Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now let's head down to the coin toss. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. We'll see how these two teams play in this game as they prepare for the opening kickoff. It's fielded at the two. He makes it to the 18-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. They come out in a five-wide set. And they make the stop at about the 27-yard line. He's going to air it long. And he's immediately tackled. And that's the way you're supposed to play pitch and catch.
Absolutely. You know, this wide receiver is a difference maker. He's one of those players that has a chance to go the distance every time you get him the ball.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. And he's shoved out of bounds around the 15-yard line.
Special here. Quick pass and a good catch, but it keeps the chains moving.
And I think it was the quick throw by the quarterback that fouled up the defense on that one. Fires out quickly to the tailback, and he's tackled at the 8.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
Quick throw in the end zone, touchdown.
You've got to give each of these guys credit for getting in sync, really fighting to create that touchdown.
And he tacks on the extra point. So a 6-play, 81-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterbacks plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
So our score, 7-0. Cincinnati gets set to kick this one away. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 28. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
He just never had a chance to get any running room. The defense was on him almost as soon as the ball was snapped.
Steps out of bounds at the 15.
He was able to deaden that kick perfectly, and he gives them a long field to work with.
Their last drive ended with a touchdown. Let's see what happens on this possession.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something, because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
He might have a chance. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. For the 20, for the 10, touchdown!
I can guarantee you'll be seeing that one in the highlight reels. What a great, great run. A real display of all the tools that he brings to the table.
And he adds the extra point. A short two-play, 85-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
You know, you always prepare your offense to think that we're going to have some success. These guys got to be coming over the sidelines after touchdown, saying, I didn't expect it to be this easy.
So the score now, 14-0. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. It's not quite a blowout, but unless they do something here, it might turn into one.
Looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one.
The Bearcats really could have overlooked this team today, I think, very easily, but they haven't done that so far.
No, you can't take anybody too lightly, and they've obviously not done that. They come out of the gate today and really put a lot of points up on the board. I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out on the field. Football and drove the length of the field to put points up on the board. And I think it really started to affect not only just the psyche of this defense, but maybe even the conditioning, where they started to get a little bit fatigued.
Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver.
Accuracy is such a vital part of being a quarterback. You've got to have an ability to lay the ball right into your guy's hands.
From their own 38-yard line, third down. Zips it to the back.
There's nothing better for a defensive mindset than to get a three and out. I mean, a turnover, of course, is a positive. Coach will take that any day of the week. But to know you've stopped the best their offense has to offer for three straight plays, that's a confidence builder.
He's tackled at the 28-yard line.
The Bearcats really came prepared to play defense today, and the plan is working.
Well, so far in this game, you've got to tip your cap to the defensive coordinator. He has clearly done a very good job of getting his team ready to play, and they have done a nice job of slowing down this very explosive offense.
Not a lot of success for this offense on their last trip out.
They've been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter.
Got an opening. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. Knocked out of bounds around the 46-yard line.
There's nothing more effective that a team can do offensively than to pound the ball right at the defense, trying to wear them down.
Bring him down at the 44.
That makes it second and eight. catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. As we change ends of the field, I don't think we're going to be seeing much of a change in the outcome. Cincinnati's lead is 2 touchdowns. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. In a perfect world, he knocks this kick down inside the 10. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. He's going to try and scramble. He's into the open field. He's tackled right around the 34. And that was a nice pickup by the quarterback.
Brad, I think this guy's amazing. He has an uncanny ability to scramble, and it showed right there on that play.
Pass complete and taken down immediately. A run, and he's taken down
at about the 43-yard line.
Up the middle for a nice game. Taken down at the 44-yard line. Here's the run right. He's got nowhere to go. And here's another third down. Catch had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. And they could really put their opponent in bad field position with a good punt here. Here's the they snap it to the upback. He's taken down at the 49-yard line. And so now the ball's turned over on downs. It was a pretty one-sided quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Down at the 49. He's at the 40. And he hits him hard at the 31. Made at the 19-yard line. First down. He gets out to about the 8. That makes it first and goal. He makes it to the 6-yard line. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. And they hit him in the backfield.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
They're at the 7. It's 3rd down. Touchdown for the tight end.
this team has so many potent weapons. It's tough to go out just one of them to stop.
He makes the PAT. Army to kick. He's to the 20. He's pushed out of bounds
at about the 23-yard line.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Tackle outside after a nice pickup. Cincinnati is up 7. Nice run to the outside. And they make the stop at the 48-yard line.
Tell you what, this defense better start to get pressure on the quarterback. They're giving him way too much time back there to throw the football.
Scrambling around, and he can't get away from the pressure.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you definitely are going to feel it the next day.
A quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. He passes it.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
They're down now, and they need to get it down to the 38. Yeah,
easy. Lucky.
Steps up an easy sack for a loss.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
Made the 26-yard line. So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finds them.
Makes the catch and he's got nowhere to go. The catch and gets out of bounds. From their own 43-yard line, first down. Tackles him hard at the 42.
Number 8 makes the tackle at the 42-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
Falling back, complete. And down he goes at the 36-yard line. Army's going to have to use their second time out of the half. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. He heaves it to the end zone. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete. The offense took an errant shot into the end zone, and I'll tell you what, that one should have been picked off.
Yeah, I'm sure he's going to hear all about that from his teammates when he comes over to the sidelines.
Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. The catch and look out, and he's tackled around the 15-yard line. Here comes the pressure. They bring him down. Looking for his man, incomplete. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. Kicks up, and it sails through the uprights. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. They'll bring him down at the 19. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Cincinnati, 4-point lead. He's out to the 30. Gains his way to the 39-yard line. The Bearcats call a timeout. That's their second of the half. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 39. And we'll probably see how far he can throw it, as it should be the last play before the half. And it's incomplete. Folks, that's the end of the first half, and this game's getting interesting. 14-10, Cincinnati.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. People say college football is evolving, it's completely an offensive game. Boy, not this one. This one has that old school, hard-nosed, tough feel to it.
Yeah, and it's good. It's kind of refreshing. And I know the younger guys, you like all the points all the time, but it's fun to watch these kind of games because you see two defenses flying around. It looks like there's 12 or 13 guys on that side of the football making big plays, making big hits, holding the offenses down. In a world where we have all the fast-paced, up-tempo, scoring points galore, it's good to see some defenses bow their necks and play some good, pretty good ball.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
Great first half. Hopefully the second half's as good. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 27. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. He fights forward to about the 30. Down and the trainers on their way out to have a look. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit. They're set to go for another round. The Black Knights quarterback down there on the sideline, and Kirk, you and I talked to him earlier this week, and he is really the main cog in this offense. Doesn't look like he's that much pain right now. They need him back on the field before this one's over. Cincinnati is up by four. He's scrambling. Tackle around the 45-yard line.
That'll bring up third and inches.
gets to about the 47-yard line. Gets out to around the 38. Incomplete. It's second and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. And he's hit immediately. And made the connection to his wide receiver.
It looked to me that the defense was more worried about the quarterback scrambling, and that's why they just gave up that touchdown.
He splits the uprights with the extra point.
A nice 9-play, 66-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So the score now, 21-10.
He's to the 20. What a collision!
Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
They'll bring him down around the 26-yard line.
We'll give the defense all the credit here. Man, that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
From their own 26-yard line, it's second down.
Makes it out to about the 36.
They call a fullback's number, and he responds by gaining 10 yards on the run. He's knocked out of bounds, right around the 20.
A weapon for your offense when you have a quarterback who can do things like that. The coach probably loves drawing up plays for this guy.
And he adds the extra point.
Army gets set to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 31-yard line.
The Black Knights have really surprised everybody in this football game.
They have not been intimidated at all, which is great to see. The attitude and effort of this team's put them in a position where they got a shot to win this game here in the second half.
Their last drive ended with a touchdown. Let's see what happens on this possession.
So much of the passing game is about the timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. Right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
Out of bounds at the 15. So the call on the field will be reversed. So we've got a first down after a great running play. Cincinnati is up 4. He's tackled at the 39. He's on the run. He gets sacked on the play. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. Now he tries to buy some time. Decides to slide. Tackle made at the 22. No gain on the play. That brings us second and 9. That's 3 down and 1 to go. The Bearcats lead it by 4. In this very pivotal fourth quarter. Just throws this one away. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Cincinnati holds a 4-point lead.
We might look back on this game when it's all over and say that's the point where they won the football game with that stop. That brings us to 15.
It's fourth down. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. It has the distance, and it's good. Like they're ready for the kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. Goes at the 29-yard line. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Here's the halfback. They go to the left for a nice game. And he's taken down at the 36. So he decides to hold on to it, and that's going nowhere. This is a great punt blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one. Tackle made the 37-yard line. A score here might effectively end this one. Cincinnati is up by a touchdown. The stop around the 41-yard line. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 41.
Ready.
Fires incomplete.
I mean, he has his wide receiver wide open. You spend all those hours during the week to be able to get prepped and ready to go. You got an open man like this, just step and deliver and make the throw.
Man, they take him down immediately. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Scrambling. He's wrapped up for the sack. And so now the ball's turned over on downs. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Gains his way to the 49-yard line. Got it, but he's going to lose yards here. They get a 1 yard loss on that one.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
So he decides to hold on to it, and it goes nowhere. Everybody bunched up tight defensively. And he's tackled at the 41.
Quarterback got so excited to make this throw that I think he just put too much on the football. His receiver was open. He just misfired.
From the 41-yard line, it's second down. Fires out to his wide out. And down he goes at about the 23-yard line. Slings it right. It's going the other way. He steps up and makes a big turnover.
Yeah, he just made a huge play right there. He knew what was coming all along.
First down. Defense will be digging in here as they're inside their own five. Just over a minute left. Army's going to use their first time out of the half here. Up the middle for a nice game.
The defense had a great opportunity there, and they let it go. This is an offense that's clearly working clock. They've got to get more aggressive defensively and attack the line of scrimmage to be able to slow down this offense from getting first down.
He fights forward to about the 13.
A yard, maybe two on the carry.
They line up at the 13. Second down. Makes it out to about the 23.
We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock.
Nothing more demoralizing for a defense than seeing the opposing quarterback take a knee.
That's going to do it for this one. Our final score, 24-7, Bearcats.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.